This time ChargerLAB got a magnetic wireless power bank from Durex. I believe everyone has heard of this brand. Its battery capacity is 10,000 mAh. In addition to wireless charging, it can also support PD 20 watts charging. Next, let's do some tests to see how its charging performance is. The box is overall gray. The specs info are printed on the back of the box, we'll talk about it later. Open the box. The box contains the magnetic power bank, a USB-A to USB-C cable, and some documents. The case is made of fire-retardant material. The surface is painted with metallic paint, giving it a full texture. There is also a large black plastic panel on the front with the word 20 watts printed on it. There is a circular display on the lower right corner, and it can show the remaining power. The wireless output panel is made of silicone. There is a built-in magnetic ring which is similar to the MagSafe. The specs info are also printed on the wireless charging panel. Model is Q9. The battery capacity is 10,000 mAh, 3.7 volts, 37 watt-hour. The rated capacity is 5,500 mAh. It can support an input power of 10 watts by lighting port. The maximum input power of the USB-C port is 18 watts. It can support output of 5 volt 2 amps, 9 volts 2.22 amps, and 12 volts 1.5 amps. It is equipped with a lightning input port, a 20 watts USB-C port, and a power button. The power button is made of metal and feels nice. The size of the power bank is about 104 by 68 by 19 millimeter. And the weight is about 200 grams. It can be easily held in one hand and is convenient to be carried out. It is wider than the iPhone 13 mini, but it does not block the camera after being adsorbed. Use it to charge other larger iPhones, it will not block the camera. It can be firmly attached to the phone and will not fall off even if it is turned upside down. Next, we will do a compatibility test on its USB-C port. The ChargerLAB Power ZKM003C shows the USB-C port can support FCP, SCP, FC, QC 3.0, QC 4+, SFCP, PD 3.0, DCP, Samsung 2A, Apple 2.4A, and PPS charging protocols. And it has three fixed PDOs of 5 volts, 3 amps, 9 volts, 2.22 amps, 12 volts, 1.67 amps, and two sets of PPS. It supports magnetic wireless charging but can also be charged via the USB-C port. There is no compatibility issue. Most phones can reach about 8 volts and 9 volts. We have compiled the test results into a bar chart. The devices that can support the PD protocol can get a higher charging power. The charging power remains in the range of 17 to 20 watts. The charging power of a few devices is in the range of 11 to 15 watts. Next, we'll use the Apple 35 watts charger to fully charge the Durex 10,000 mAh magnetic power bank via the USB-C port. The charger and the power bank will be put into a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank throughout the test. Here is the charging curve made by the PC software of KM003C. The voltage is always around 9 volts. The charging curve can be divided into two parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 18 watts for the first 38 minutes. But at 8 to 10 minutes, the power dropped to 4 watts. Then the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 3 hours and 31 minutes to be fully charged. We plotted into another curve to see how fast it can be. It can be charged to 50% in 45 minutes and 80% in 1 hour and 37 minutes. And it can be fully charged in 3 hours and 31 minutes. Then use the lighting port to fully charge the Durex 10,000 mAh magnetic power bank. The voltage is always around 5 volts. The charging curve can be divided into two parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 9 watts for the first 1 hour and 44 minutes. Then the power gradually drops to almost zero. It takes 4 hours and 15 minutes to be fully charged. We plotted into another curve to see how fast it can be. It can be charged to 50% in 1 hour and 27 minutes and 80% in 2 hours and 25 minutes. And it can be fully charged in 4 hours and 15 minutes. Next is the discharging test. Let it continue to output at different currents and voltages until the power is exhausted and record the data. The test results are as follows. First, let the power bank continue to output at a power of 5 volts 3 amps 15 watts, and the power was exhausted in 1 hour and 6 minutes. The released battery energy is about 16.39 watt-hours, so the efficiency of the power bank is about 44.3%. Let it continue to output at 9 volts 2.22 amps 20 watts. The output is interrupted at 26 minutes. The released battery energy is about 8.46 watt-hour, and the remaining power is 35%. Let it continue to output at 12 volts 1.67 amps 20 watts. The output is interrupted at 26 minutes. The released battery energy is about 8.73 watt-hour, and the remaining power is 40%. We infer that the output may have stopped due to overheating of the battery core. Then we are going to the temperature test. We put the power bank into a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank and recorded the highest temperature on the front and back after charging at 12 volts 1.67 amps 20 watts for 20 minutes. After 20 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature on the front is 36 degrees Celsius. And the maximum temperature on the back is 37.7 degrees Celsius. The heat is mainly concentrated on the magnetic ring. Well, that would be all the tests for the Durex 10000mAh magnetic power bank. It can charge your phone both wired and wirelessly. However, according to tests, its discharge efficiency is relatively low, and there are power outages. But it is well compatible with various iPhone models and does not block the camera. And there are no compatibility issues. Okay. That's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.